is up, my Terraria enthusiasts? Why is there an item here? I am Kirkihi in any case, and this is Terraria, the stars above, where today we've got a busy day ahead of us, so the sooner we get started, the better. And the first thing we're going to do... Cool, got a mining potion. The first thing we're going to do is make a new pickaxe, because guess what? I'm not used to doing modded stuff, so... Yeah, post-Moonlord stuff, completely forgot about actually making a new pickaxe. Okay, so it doesn't really matter which one we make, it's just a preference of appearance, I guess, and I like the Stardust one, so... Boop. Boosh. Goodbye, drill. I can't put it away there. So, as you may have noticed there, it says, can mine newly bloom ore. That is one of our main tasks of the day. We're going to head over into the jungle, and we're going to mine some newly bloom. All right, now, let's see if this works, because, yeah, I need this. And I need to favorite these, so I don't accidentally sell them. I went over there once already, and it didn't work out, because... The spelunker was not spelunkering right. It just wasn't making the ore show up. So I have no idea what Yuli Bloom ore even looks like. So I don't really know what I'm looking for. I'd say shout it out if you see it. But, you know, it's not going to make a huge difference in the end, right? Get away from me, Plaguebringer. Go on. Shoo. No one likes you. Go away. I would say this ugly clump of poo... Looks like Yuli Bloom ore, or will be our Yuli Bloom ore, and sure enough, it is. Get out of here. You know, this summon right here really feels like the Terra Prisma. Would you not agree to that? Like, seriously, it's just all over the place, much like the Terra Prisma is. I think it'll end up being a favorite of mine and modded. But, you know, they're always short-lived is the problem. I have to say, so far, Yuli Bloom seems quite rare. Which is not a good sign. I was hoping this would be done quick, because at this point, this deep in the mod, I'm so over mining for stuff. I don't want to do it. But not only am I stuck doing it, I'm stuck doing it a lot, apparently. Actually, I say a lot, but it'll be more like a long time, maybe this last time. I don't know. I know one thing, though. We need to swap this and this just for a little more oomph in our digging. There we go. That's a little better. Now, Yuli Bloomore, would you kindly show your damn face? I'm not getting any for crap. Well, it took me quite a while, but I think we finally have enough of the Yuli Bloom ore, so let's deposit all that and hope we can make some bars out of it. I don't know if there's anything extra needed or not, but we'll see. It does not seem like anything extra is needed, so let's craft up a bunch of these son of my guns. Yeah, I didn't go overboard at all. That only got me 198. Of course, 05 per. I'm going to grab one of these out. We're going to see. Oh my god, there's so much. Okay, so one thing on the agenda. Two things on the agenda. If there's a pickaxe. Yeah, I was going to say, if there's a pickaxe, we will need it. So we'll need to make the pickaxe. We'll need to make our armor. And I haven't looked at anything else yet because there's a lot of stuff here. Looks like some of this stuff will not be craftable until after we take on Poltergeist or the Ceaseless Void, which is our choice for the next boss. So, oh boy. I think I have the stuff for that now. Yeah, I'm going to make up a bunch of stuff and then we'll go through it afterward. That's probably the best way to do this because I'm slow at crafting and I don't need this video being 2 hours for just crafting 5 things. Okay, small problem right off the bat. I don't know where my divine geodes are. Apparently, I have none. What? I didn't use them all, did I? Well, I got some fighting to do. Well, that's annoying. I went and fought Providence a few times, died a few times, and I didn't need to. It's a damn A and not an E. Damn it! Why would they put a Tarragon instead of Tarragon? That kind of pisses me off! Alright, let's see how this fares over what we currently have for armor. So I did make the magic and rogue just because we haven't had a chance to use rogue in a while. I kind of want to do today's boss with rogue if I can. But first we'll make the comparison between these here. So we're currently at 94 magic. Boom, boom. Are you the magic one? You are. So So that gives us a little extra defense. Let's see what the buff here is. Reduces enemy spawn rates, increased heart pickup. Enemies have a chance to drop extra hearts on death. On every fifth critical strike, you'll fire a leaf storm. Magic projectiles heal you on enemy hits. Amount healed is based on projectile damage. So this is pretty damn good magic armor. It's better than this for sure. So let's see what the rogue class has here. After every 25 rogue critical hits, you'll gain 3 seconds of damage immunity. That's pretty cool. Effect can only occur once every 30 seconds, which if you're... maybe you could get 30 hits or 30 criticals in 30 seconds. I don't know. While under the effect, debuff will gain 10% increased rogue stealth builds while slower, blah blah blah. Maximum 15. Rogue stealth reduces when you attack, it does not reduce while moving. The higher your rogue stealth, the higher the rogue damage, crit, and movement speed. That's sort of like a double-edged sword because your speed would be all over the place depending on how frequently you're attacking. But by the way that sounds, anyway, as you're like attacking, your stealth meter drains, right? And that makes it so your movement and stuff goes down. That's kind of a double-edged sword for sure. Oh well, we'll make do with it. Oh, I almost forgot about this. This is actually one of the things we wanted to do today. So, voltage regulator. Ooh, what's this? Well, we don't have the swirly's dark sun fragments. I wonder what you come from. Doesn't matter. We'll worry about that another time. Let's get this crafted. Plop this on our machine. I thought I was the mutant up there for a moment. There we are. And now we can craft, or we can... Where is it? Oh, right. Please move. Yeah, I already have it setting in here. This is the only one we have left to decode, so let's do this. Oh my god, that took a lot. Okay, so it says, I have since made progress to even greater weapons than these, but they remain creations to be proud of. No progress can be made without desire that comes from dissatisfaction. Addendum, the time has come. You are ready. So this here, I think... makes a bunch of new recipes for us. I'm not sure how that works. Maybe you guys can let me know. Because, yeah. Why the hell is that? There we go. Why'd that stay open when I stepped away from it? I'm gonna put the last blueprint up here, actually. Or schematic. Just so it can be with the rest of its family. I don't think I need some of this stuff anymore. Why is there a vial mushroom in here? So here we have the elderberry, which is gonna give us a little more health. 25 made our hearts nice and blue. Okay, I think I've gone through everything. Why is my summon crooked? There we go. Yeah, in any case, I think I got everything made that I can make that's worth making right now. We got our armor on. So we'll start with Profane Partisan. It shoots like this, not too bad. 700 and some rogue damage, over 2 grand for stealth. For magic, we have Nasty Plasma Rifle. Which is very loud. That classes is very fast, or insanely fast. I don't agree, but another magic ruthless this thing, which is very loud. I won't know what any of it's like until I actually get to try it on enemies. Then we have the Divine Retribution, which more of the same, but it all homes back in onto you, I think. Or where you were, maybe? Not sure, but that could be interesting. It's ungodly weak, though. And we have this for, and I don't have that charge up. I gotta charge that one up to try it. I'm not a huge fan of these weapons that you have to charge up. They typically end up being pretty decent or really good, but the fact they get weaker over time as the charge lessens kind of really sucks with them. And they take forever to charge up. They are very slow to charge up. All right, let's see how it goes on enemies. It does erupt immediately if it does hit an enemy, which is good. I always have to come here for enemies too. God damn it, if you miss though. I mean, it does seem like it hits pretty good, I think, but if you miss, it's such a long wait, and you can't exactly toss them out super duper fast either, unfortunately. Okay, so just learned something. We're already where we needed to be. Please move. Reforging this stuff zaps the charge, which is one of the dumbest things I've ever heard of. What is he taking the freaking batteries out of it and putting dead ones in on us? Freaking goddamn idiot here is an awful crook. I'm glad we have someone stealing money from him. Alright, so all we have left to do is take on our boss of the day, which... it's gonna bug me if I don't go back and do the Frost Legion in that. I'll have to do those at some point, maybe off camera. In any case, either the Ceaseless Void, or Cygnus. And I'm thinking, since this one's up top, he's meant to be the easier, use it in the dungeon. Okay, so we're headed on over to the dungeon. Where's my... here he is. Hey, friend. I need you for a moment. You are my dungeon teleport potion. Oh, hey, guys. This means I'm probably going to need to make an arena, and I'm thinking right where we're falling would make a perfect arena. Best get to cracking. You know what? I made this for a reason. This wasn't the reason, but... oh, well. Man, get away from me, dude. I am dying in the worst of ways, and I can't see. Get out of here, enemies. There we go. I think... once I get rid of this, anyway. I think I have the arena all but situated here now. I mean, it's not as big as I would like it, but we do need to keep our dungeon intact. And this is probably the best spot I had to do it with, and we're just gonna hope for the best. Either way, once I get these enemies out of here... oh, great, there's a freaking ball in here, too. We will... if I can find the thing... try this out for the... oh, God! I'm on the wrong weapon set here. Okay. So I can take out the orbs. Take out the orby boys. They have a gravitational field to them, which is not good. Oh my god, stop it. This area is definitely not doing it for me. Okay, okay. Stop. Throwing some bombs at ya. This is going terribly. I hit R by mistake. Okay. Oh, that was actually doing quite a bit of damage here for half a second. I forget what this was like. I was right, lightning that summoned in, but it's probably not going to work in here. Well, this is for the best, because I had a stupid freaking featherfall potion on me, and it was really messing me up bad. And now I can properly prepare and be ready. All right, let's hope things go a little better this time. Really bad if you get caught by those stupid orbs. I was hoping this weapon would be a good choice. But it's a double-edged sword for me once again, because I can't really see what's going on for crap. Man, I really wish I had a bigger arena, though. I am a person that needs movement. I do not maneuver in tight areas very well. I may be able to make it a little taller, if anything. Right, where are you, friend? Yeah, you stay still, and we'll be on good terms here. I wish this anti-gravity wasn't a... I can't jump? No, I couldn't jump. What? I can't jump. I can't do anything. What's going on? Does this boss prevent you from jumping? It must. I don't know how you're supposed to avoid anything when you have no vertical movement, but sure. I think this... oh, great. I'm at that point. I can't jump again. Oh, no. It's letting me jump up a little bit now. But this is... seemingly the best weapon for me to use in this fight. I think half the problem, like with that other thing, it is stronger, but the fact I can't see with it. There's just too much visual noise on the screen. When you have, like, there's no less than 20 orbs here to fight. When you have a bunch of stuff on top of that just cluttering your screen up, that's just sensory overload for me. I'm struggling to get away from these things so bad. There we go. Finally get him on one side of me again. I don't like how he just sucks you in. Maybe in this spot, since it's just that in itself I have to focus on, work on the harder hit. Since nothing... well, nothing was coming through there. One thing I learned with this mouse I have right now as well is it's kind of garbage for scrolling through this game. It takes 3 scrolls, like click, 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 which is the click that you get within the scroll. It takes 3 of those clicks in order to register through one, which is garbage. Just go across 3 items there, I had to register 9 clicks, which makes it a little hard to tell what's going on, where you're going, how you're doing, and all that brick-brack. Okay, I think I'm just gonna stick on this. this seems to do more damage than the thing worth 700 because of how it attacks. Yeah, you keep coming to me, and we'll keep this stuff away from you. Oh, I'm not gonna survive. Yeah, I knew I was done. I had nowhere to go. I don't have much time left for recording, so I gave Rogue a chance. I'm gonna switch over to Magic, because Magic... I'm just more familiar with the weaponry and stuff, and I know what I can do with it and how to deal with it in these situations. Actually, I don't know what to do with it in this case, because I've got a lot of new magic. I can say this right now, this, although it's incredibly weak, does exactly what I wanted it to do. It homes heavy. And because of that, it just shreds. It absolutely shreds. Once I get to this phase, though, I could switch over to this. I can't jump again, which really costs me whenever I'm not able to jump. I gotta block off some of these spots, too. That's costing me big time, getting caught in an area like I did just there. Let's switch over to the bees, actually. Doesn't matter now. All right, so the one big thing I'm learning with this fight is the less you move, the better time you're gonna have, even in this phase. And now I'm talking, that'll prove me wrong. Yeah, totally proving me wrong. I can't get away from moving again. Before, I barely moved from one spot, and they were just coming in such a way that I just had to do little hops and stuff to get around them. But nope, they gotta always prove you wrong when you go to show it. It's no different than like a dog or a cat in that regard. Like, oh, look, my cat can do this, or my dog can do this. You go to show someone that trick? Nah, they're having none of it. They're having absolutely none of it. They're like, what? I don't know what you're talking about. 100%. Damn it! Phase is the worst. Ooh, got really lucky there. Oh, God. I keep getting stuck in that goddamn hole. Okay, you come to me, little papa. I need you to desperately die. Why are you not dying? My hits aren't doing anything, are they? I see him healing negative 600 damage. I'm just meant to survive this, aren't I? Yep, that looks to be the case. Oh my god, I hope I don't ever have to fight him again. My god, he was a frustratingly annoying fight more than anything. Just no room. Had absolutely no room. I'd love to know what these souls are for. I'm sure I'm going to need them, so I'm going to make sure I pick them up before I leave. But once again, you're getting a chance to see why I like the magic class, though. Even with modded, people seem to go above and beyond to make magic, like, super OP. Well, I'm not sure about OP, like, as far as this goes, it's an absolutely weak weapon, but it's really strong at the same time because of the sheer amount it shoots out. I tried using this thing, but no, that was a no-go. It's supposed to have a secondary attack as well. There it is. Let's put this in here. Actually, I want to see what they're for real quick before we end the video. Okay, so it goes into the... what? Is that not this? How did I make this then, if it goes into that? Have I been able to get Phantoplasm all this time? I'm so confused. Eldritch Soul Artifact. Equipable Knowledge. Boost melee speed by 10%, range velocity by 25, rogue 15, max minion 2, and reduces mana cost by 15%. God. Okay, so this will go into that. Oh, there's still a lot more other stuff to go into it, too, so there's no worries about that yet. I think I can make this stuff now. The Bloodstone. Cosmic Worm. Summons the Devourer of Gods. Warning, some sentinels have not been truly defeated yet and will spawn at full power with this fight. Not consumable. I'm going to make that right now, but I'm not going to use it. Staff of Blushy? This blue is so hard to read. Two magic damage. Uses 156 mana. Hold your mouse, wait, and put your trust in the power of blue magic. What? Okay, looking things over, aside from what we made, there's not really anything we can make yet. With the exception of, like, this. which is fine. Let's, really? I don't know what a Cosmic Kunai is. Oh, you come from Cygnus, Envoy of the Devourer. Sure? And we can make dye. No, I'm not wasting it on dye. Let's see what we get out of the bag, and then we'll wrap this one up. So we got a Ceaseless Void Mask. Warding the evolution, you reflect the projectiles when they hit you. Reflect the projectiles deal no damage to you. This reflect has 120 second cooldown, which is shared with all other dodges. Okay. If this effect triggers you, get a health regen boost for 5 seconds. If the same enemy projectile type hits you again, you'll resist its damage by 15%. Cool. This is where we get Dark Plasma. Okay. You know I gotta do it. Oh, it's very blue! It's very blue! Oh, come on. You guys knew I was gonna do this, right? I had to at least once. I wanna see. Oh, man, we're doing so little damage. Oh my god, he hurts us so bad. Okay, I don't know what's with the funky sky, but my god, you're a big wormy boy, I'll give you that! I had to do it, I had to do it. I wanted to see what he looked like, I had to do it. Bye! Whew, well, that was thrilling, enthralling. He's gonna be a tough fight when we come to him, I think. He's gonna be a fight that we just have to run one way and keep doing this. That's what I'm seeing. In any case, why is my summon sideways again? Stop that. In any case, if you did happen to enjoy this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. Yeah, I hope I don't end up having to take on Poltergeist or Ceaseless Void again to get more of those, whatever they were. They're gone. They're not in here now. Because he's tough. He's a frustrating fight. You know what? I'm going to wrap this up quick because I still have time to get a walk in for today before it gets too cool out. So, yeah, check out these videos off to the side, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.